Script for the hometown movie of 1929. The Cornwall hometown movie was made during the winter and spring of 1928-29 by Laura B. Dempsey, wife of Dr. George R. Dempsey, Cornwall physician from 1917 to 1967. It was shown at a gala entertainment sponsored by the Auxiliary of the Cornwall American Legion Post on April 12, 1929. The event was a benefit to fund the Legion's projects, one of which was the ambulance for the Cornwall Hospital then being built. The program included a gymnastic drill by the school students, a concert by the NYMA band, and a one-act play, Night at an Inn, by the Storm King School. The final number and climax of the evening was the movie. The CHHS auditorium was filled to capacity with people curious to see if they appeared in the film. The first scene shows a view of river and mountains, a scene from the Spruce Street estate of George Mears, now owned by the Brabson family. A small rustic pergola then stood at the foot of the lawn overlooking a sweeping view of the Hudson Highlands. The Red Men, or Wayoronek tribe as they were officially called, had been a strong fraternal organization in Cornwall for several decades. They built a large building for a meeting place, Red Men's Hall, in the Upper Village. By 1928, the lodge had dwindled in numbers, but they were persuaded to don their regalia and meet the photographer at the boulevard. Then an undeveloped wooded area for the filming of this sequence. After performing a war dance, the Red Men enact a torture at the stake with rotund Gus Nystrom as the victim. Then they run the gauntlet. Among the group are Dr. Ralph Waldo Thompson, with long hair. Some of the employees of Cox's store pose in front of the store. Isaac M. Cox, Anna Fanning, Frank Kniff, Percy Warner, and Norman Chatfield. These are butchers Everett Clark and Charles Mackey. Here, Dr. Dempsey is listening to Ed Wurzeby, owner of a men's clothing store in Main Street. Irving C. Kent, Lower Village Butcher, is making a delivery. Clarence Van Slyke, he and his brother Vincent ran Braden's Preparatory School for West Point and Annapolis. This is Ulysses Grant Clark of the clan of Clark Butchers. Edwin Knapp, who had a feed store on Main Street, later Edgar's. This reluctant subject is druggist Robert Hazard. This is Hank Warden of Frithcliff. Bob Smith, the genial Scotch barber. His shop was located in the Frithcliff Club. Dr. Myron Osterhout, who had an office where Dr. Troyda located in later years. William D. Conning of Conning & Cox Hardware Store on Main Street, now Ushman's. Charles Waters had a drugstore at the corner of Duncan Avenue and Hudson Street. These are garage owners, Jim Lewis, Harry Keeble, Len Lewis, Oscar Ward, and Andrew Speeder. Here are Bill Cooney, Walter Dayton, garbage collector, and plumber. Ed Stoddard. Creswell McLaughlin was a newspaper man and well-known public speaker. Mrs. Hawkins and her niece Virginia Engbers. Mrs. Hawkins worked in the newspaper store next to the present Cumberland Farm on Hudson Street. Here are Donald Ketchum and Charles Cox on their way home from school. Ted Fowler, whose property was off Cedar Lane. This is Harry Hankin. Laura Farmer and unknown. Blanche Palmer, wife of NYMA treasurer A.C. Palmer. She was active in the garden club and at the old homestead. Steve Davenport, a longtime member of the Highland Engine Company. And Sandy Bedford, a well-known character along Main Street. Trainer and Cooney. This is Mary Harris, Cornwall's visiting nurse. John Lorch, who lived in the brick house at the corner of Academy Avenue. Sid Pope, Cox store employee and son of Daniel E. Pope. J. Newton Engbers, real estate man and owner of a newspaper store. Also an avid sportsman and hunter. James Gibson. Plumber Henry Hahn, father of Connie Hahn. Mrs. McLaughlin, née Jager, wife of Creswell. And 4W Gilio, then commander of the American Legion Post. Louis Shavashev, photographer and CHHS industrial arts teacher. Another shot of Mrs. Palmer. William Appleby Robinson and his wife. They lived at Knowles Shoal, later the home of Dr. Kearney. Robinson had a fine voice, gave singing lessons, and directed church choirs and musical shows. Mrs. Robinson was active in many women's organizations. Billy Ward. Ezra P. Thompson, auctioneer. Employees of Firth Carpet Company, one of the town's largest industries, later Majestic Weaving. Another flourishing industry was Meat and Tab Company at Cornwall Landing. Pictured are Thomas K. Taft, George G. Horobin, John Burke, John Preston, Dick Larden, and Gertrude Pope. Here's Dan Little, known as Uncle Dan, for many years custodian at CHHS. He lived to be over 100. Here are Joe Mead and Bert Edsel. Joe McCarthy. St. Thomas Church. Notice the old church, now replaced. Cadets from NYMA are leaving the church. Here's Father Prendergast, a well-loved figure. St. John's Episcopal Church. The only people who can be identified are the Robinsons and Reverend Frank R. Wilson, who went from Cornwall to Roosevelt's church at Hyde Park. The Cornwall Methodist Church. Again, the congregation are not known. The Presbyterian Church on Hudson Street. The minister is Reverend William Arthur Berner. Two members of the CHS faculty, Principal Herman C. Woodworth and Elsie Kauser, a longtime teacher. This is CHHS, now an elementary school. The principal is John Hitzelberg. This is Mountain Road after a snowstorm. Picturesque, but more treacherous than today's wider road. Here's Storm King School, the main building and the annex, both gone, and the cottage still standing. This is the headmaster, Mr. Shortledge, and the Shortledge children sleigh riding. The woman is Mrs. Shortledge. Now to the New York Military Academy, Captain Tully and his band. This group was featured at such length here in appreciation for performing at the benefit show. Thank you. Here is Leo Fanning, then the sole police officer in Cornwall on Hudson. Jim Gibson. Frank Mead, choir director. Frank Walsh, Cornwall on Hudson postmaster. King Bill Burke, a prominent legionnaire. Mrs. Everson of Wood Avenue, an expert paper hanger, widow of a Mead and Taft carpenter, both Swedes. And the Hennessy twins, Doris and Jane, with their mother Hazel. The Stoddard twins, sons of Edward and Alma Stoddard. No. Officers of the Cornwall Savings Bank, Townsend D. Wood and Gilbert T. Cox. This building is now owned by John Orlandi. Cornwall National Bank officials, Joe Grubbs and John S. Holleran, Jr.
Yes, sir. As I live and breathe, I'm blue, I guess.
The Cornwall Village Board, William Maroney, Mayor, Charles Slater, Joe Horobin, John Clarkson, Thomas Ashman. George Toombs, a lifelong resident, Spanish War veteran, policeman, and carpenter. Dr. Dempsey relaxing at home with his perennial pipe. General Milton F. Davis, distinguished superintendent at NYMA. One of the few living veterans of Civil War, decorating the graves of his comrades. A scene from Memorial Day 1926. Thank you. Funeral directors James Bevins, Elmer Ostrander, and Edward L. Silcox.
When it's 12 o'clock and you wanna go